referee just checking everything all right there. And the other bit of candy news on the injury front is that Byron Anthony is now off his crutches and is walking unaided. Referee Sargeson checking, and Newport, in their third strip of all black with an amber trim, will be attacking the goal away to our left-hand side, the club end of the ground. Long ball from him up to the head of Mark Hughes, the Morecambe skipper, but gets intercepted by Mike Flynn. And Newport have it on the far side of the field. Ball comes in. Jones is there!
Second minute, Jones.
What a good way to announce yourself to the supporters of Newport County.
First touch
with the foot. He's taken a couple of throw-ins, but Billy Jones scores the goal. And what do you think, George?
Beautiful strike from Billy Jones there. The first touch. It was on the far side, I think it was with Colin Washington, just got to the byline, pulled the ball back, it came past three or four players, just set up lovely for him on a plate.
Where the ball actually went out of play. Takes the throw into Williams, locks it on, but Newport clear their lines, and it's picked up by Connor Washington, who drifts past his man, he's into the multi area, but Roach comes out and saves that. It could have easily been 2-0, Tim.
But the youngster did so well, didn't he? The keeper now at the angle, he came straight out. He was quick. He was like Rhys Lynham.
Yeah, and the Morecambe bench is not very happy. Ken McKenna, the assistant to Jim Bentley, complaining to the fourth official that was a bit of shirt tugging. But it's Ellison and shooting and bending that around the Newport right-hand post. Goal kick to Newport County, and Morecambe is again possession. Drummond to Sampson. Through it goes to Ellison, who is finally adjudged to be offside, Tim.
Yeah, he was waiting for him to touch the ball, basically, wasn't he? And when he became actively involved, he was offside. He was about 3 or 4 yards off.
Looking for Flynn, doesn't find him, finds right of Morecambe, but Zabrowski picks it up, shoots! Oh, and Barry Roach has to dive to his right-hand side, tip that round the post. First corner of the game to Newport County. Corner then to Newport County. Jones takes it into the box, headed away by Ellison. Comes to Chapman, who heads that ball forward. Cleared away upfield by Drummond. Sampson goes on the chase, but Pipe is there to get a header down. It's picked up and played away to the far side. Crossed in, Ellison's at the far post, headed back across, and there's the equaliser.
Oh, goal, Naylor.
It's an own goal, it's come off Tom Naylor.
So there we are at 11 minutes and OG, unfortunately, to Tom Naylor. And that all came, George, from a corner at one end of the ground.
Yeah, very direct, Morecambe, as Tim said.
And Chapman goes to take it, throws it to Worley, gets it under control. Puts a high cross into the box. Zabrowski is there, but Barry Roach saves, clears away first time downfield, and eludes Andy Hughes. But fortunately for County, Amond couldn't get the necessary touch on the ball. Pipe gets a touch on it, and it's knocked away by Wilmot to Washington, to Zabrowski. Over the halfway line comes Zabrowski, feeds it through to Washington. Again, Washington there on the box, gets blocked by Hughes, back to Zabrowski, and the follow-up shot goes wide. And then cleared away by Worley upfield towards Connor Washington, who gets trampled down there, nothing given again. And it's this time Wright playing a long ball again. And back there comes Naylor, and he gets caused problems, headed off the line by Worley. And they certainly are causing problems out there, Tim.
Yeah, they are indeed, but County there almost did their own downfall. Careless defending, you know, not calling, going, I don't know what it was there, a complete mix-up with a couple of the defenders, and I think Naylor was one involved there.
Still not where it should be, in my opinion, but never mind. Hits it down the line to Amond, who crosses first time. Ellison comes in on it, and the header goes wide.
It's what I just said again. Free kick, one player peels off, ball's played in, three movement, and the ball's headed over. But it's with Chapman now. Chapman plays the ball forward. Washington goes for it. He's onside. What can he do? He's in the box. He checks, he takes it inside, he lays it to Zabrowski. It's back, it's with Wilmot. Wilmot steps inside when he shoots. It's there! It's there now! It was in from Wilmot. First of all, the linesmen are giving it. It's Robbie Wilmot. After 23 minutes, Charlie, it's 2-1.
And by my reckoning, is that Robbie Wilmot's first league goal since he was signed from Cambridge United? Robbie Wilmot, great goal.
Great strike from Robbie Wilmot there. Cambridge were playing it a bit in the box a little bit. It looked like the chance had gone, but then Wilmot cuts in on his right hand side and just pile drives a shot. The keeper got a hand on it, but he couldn't do anything about it. Hit the crossbar, bounced in, and for good measure, I think it was Billy Jones just putting it in because it bounced out. The liner had already given it as Wilmot's goal.
It is a free kick with 26 and a half minutes in. They lead by 2-1. This is pure excitement here at Rodney Parade. You're listening to iRadio, Newport City Radio. Free kick is played into the box. Keeper punches. It's Chapman. And it's still back. It's Chapman again. It's now with Jones, but it's over the top. And in fact, it was Naylor. And it's gone for a goal kick. Right in front of me. Jones with the free kick. Left-footed. And Wally goes to meet it. Doesn't. But Flynn meets it. Flynn's taking it through. He's found Jones. Jones steps inside, he shoots! Keeper's made a brilliant save! We know he's got a great left peg, but my goodness me, it's Naylor. A corner kick.
Naylor.
By Flynn, into Podonius, into this side, where Williams, who's trying his luck over this side, wins the ball. Wilmot comes off him. Podonius fires Drummond. The County have won it back, and Zabrowski is picking it up. He's got Washington peeling away. It's Zabrowski, he's going to win himself a corner kick. And we've played 35 minutes, a second corner kick. This will be a left-footed in-swinger. After 36 minutes, in comes the corner, headed. Oh, and it's only just headed over. And it was Naylor again with the header, and that was close. He puts his hand on his head, and that was so nearly 3-1. Flynn picks it up, plays it into the channel to Jones. Play to Flynn. Flynn, man on, the crowd shout. Checks back, play to Chapman. Chapman looks for an outlet, finds Wilmot. Played back to Naylor. Now it's with Hughes. Hughes surely will look up and play the ball forward, looking for Washington. Ball is headed out by Parrish, and it's good football by County. The ball is thrown in. It's with Chapman. Chapman played into Sabrowski's feet, edge of the area. Turned smartly, played to Pipe on the far side. Pipe takes the ball forward. What can Pipe do with this? Takes the ball outside towards the byline. Crosses. Beautiful cross. It's fell for Jones to have another one, but he plays and checks the ball back. It's with Robbie Wilmot. Now it's with Jones, just inside the touchline. Jones crosses to the near post, but it's into Roach's grateful arms. But Hughes launches it forward. It was route one as the ball ends up with Diani. Diani coming forward, checks and then plays the ball forward. Ball is headed. Danger here, but it's over the top from Ryan Williams. But again, it was 1-2-3 in the box. Have a go. And they won't be in any rush to take this, because I make it. We're playing now added time in this first half. Newport County AFC 2-1, Morecambe 1. It's half time. Charlie, it's back to you.
Thank you, Tim. And at the end of just over 45 minutes, Newport County are leading by 2-1. Williams in the centre circle. Still got the bright sunlight here at Rodney Parade as Drummond picks up the ball and knocks it to the head of Michael Flynn. Upfield it goes to Ellison, who turns and breaks forward. He's got pace at Kevin Ellison, and he shoots! And the ball whistles past the right-hand post of Lenny Fidgley. And the Morecambe right back hits it upfield towards Ellison, who doesn't get the head on it, but it's knocked on into the path of Zabrowski, and he shoots, and it goes over. And that was a great chance for Chris Zabrowski there, Tim. And Wilmot's in there, plays it towards Zabrowski, who can't control it. Right, plays it forward. Samson to Williams, who's in space, lays it on to Diani, who shoots straight into the arms of Lenny Fridgley, who had that under his control all the way, putting it back to Tom Naylor. back again to Flynn, back to Cole, hits it across to this side trying to pick out Pipe. It's cut off by Diani, and then long ball forward from Sampson, and it could be an own goal, and it is an own goal, and the second goal for Morecambe. Tom Naylor's got two own goals.
He has indeed. It's another own goal for Tom Naylor, and it's absolutely extraordinary, isn't it?
Oh well, what do you think, George?
Yeah, quite looking over there actually. The Morecambe fans didn't even realise they had scored, but yeah, Naylor and Pidgley, a lack of communication, a bit of a mix-up there. Looked like he tried to head it back to the keeper, and Pidgley was wrong-footed, and Tom Naylor might score a hat-trick of own goals at this rate, but it's 2-2, largely against the run of play, that one.
And it'll be a new ball throw-in, much the annoyance of Ryan Williams, who could become the first player to see yellow this afternoon for his outburst. So Ryan Williams, played in the Welsh Premiership with Rhyl, has a yellow card and goes into Mr. Sargeson's book. Downfield, header by Naylor away towards Zabrowski, but it's one in the air by Kenyon. Comes back again, Naylor gets impeded, Ellison goes down, and it will be free kick to Morecambe, 25 yards out. Ryan Williams, who scored that winning goal against Wolverhampton Wanderers in the Capital One Cup, is over the ball, steps up to it, and it goes into the wall on this occasion. He passes it back to Drummond, and his pass over the top goes safely through to Pidgley. And Wilmot hits it forward into Washington. He's in space. Chapman is charging in towards the box. He lays it in the path of Chapman, and he can't reach it as the ball's played in. It goes out on the far side, and it'll come towards Washington, who gets beaten in the air by Mark Hughes. Flynn, though, wins it back. Picked up by Billy Jones, who drives forward. Jones, who got that all-important for opening goal, to Washington, who turns. He beats two men. Then he goes down, the referee awards a corner, and it'll be Counter's first corner of the second half.
Plays the ball to Crowe, inside, Wilmot goes forward, shows a little bit too much. Fair tackle, says the referee, and it's the visitors coming forward now, and Amon's coming with it, and he plays the ball to the far side. Ball is headed on, and they appeal for a penalty, and the referee's going to give it, and it's the linesman who's given it. And the linesman thought it was. The referee was well back, and he said no. And it's given a he's given it as a penalty, and it's probably going to be. Is it going to be a red card or is it going to be a yellow card? It's Tom Naylor who's given it away. What an unfortunate afternoon it's been from him. And it's what I said. It's a penalty kick. The referee didn't give it. It was the assistant referee over the far side who gave it. And it's number 27. It's Amond who's going to take it. And oh dear, 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 all of a sudden, County from being 2-1 ahead, they're staring defeat in the face here. So it's 27, it's Amond, it's 70 minutes gone, it's Amond against Pidgley, it's Amond, and it's 3-2 to the visitors, and they're now ahead. Charlie.
Well, catastrophe is a word that you don't hear very often when you're talking in Newport County, but this afternoon is talking, is turning very much, George, into a catastrophe. And there's no real explanation for it, because in some ways they've dominated the play and they've allowed this to happen.
But it's the visitors coming forward, the ball is played through, and they've still got it. And the ball is played looking for Ellison, and Ellison is almost clear in on them. But the keeper comes and the keeper gets it, and he has got it. But defensively, the County look at sixes and sevens. It's Jones who's going to take it. In it comes. In comes the corner kick. It's headed, though. And it was, in fact, Naylor who's headed it wide of goal. It is a goal kick. It's back to you, Charlie. And I feel really sorry for the player. Yakubu is now on, and County now, but just they've simply got to really sort this out. As Yakubu doesn't get it, Ellison does. They could be in here for fourth, and in fact it's taken a save there from Pidgley. Chapman goes forward, plays a great ball over the top. What a pass that is to Jolly. Jolly's got the ball, he cuts inside. What's Christian Jolly going to do? He takes the ball, and the player is still fighting for it, is Christian Jolly, but he has fouled the Morecambe player, and they have a free kick. It comes to nothing.
There's just that feeling within the game. And it's something I always wonder about as Ellison collides on the edge of the box and Morecambe will have a free kick.
Well, one thing I know that's going to happen is that they have a free kick, do they? And Ellison will take him. I think Pipe's just been booked, is he not? Oh no, it's not, it's Worley. Worley, Pipe walked past him, so it was Worley who's been booked. It's in a fairly central position, it's about 21 yards out, and he's going to have a crack at this. And it's Williams then with the free kick. It's it. Oh, I tell you what a great save, because that was destined for the net, and that was a great save, and he's kept County in it there. And for a second, as Wilmot, who's County playing so well, is Robbie Wilmot, tries to find Washington. Chapman heads it over to the far side, and County still piling forward. Is Christian Jolly taking it, and Jolly still got it. He's beaten two or three players, he's taken it 2-3, and he's won himself a free kick on the far side. And here's going to be another booking, and is it Kenyon, I think, who's going to be booked? I think it is, yeah, he's going in the referee's notebook. So after Worley, it's now Kenyon. And Pipe goes for it, and Pipe has got the ball, but it's back with Flynn. Flynn plays it through to Jolly. Jolly, though, falls, and he's beaten the player, and he takes it on. The referee plays well, does well there, and the ball is out, and it's gone for a goal kick. It was true, but Christian Jolly did well there. The referee did exactly the right thing by playing the advantage. But it hasn't... And now the referee had played the advantage and he's given the goal kick, but you can't change once you've done it and the ball is carried on. Then you can't suddenly change your mind again. Ellison heads it backwards, but it's with Chapman. Chapman plays it forward. That's poor from Chapman, and it's the referee's whistle, and the visitors have the 3 points. It's finished. Newport County AFC 2, Morecambe 3. It's a disappointment, Charlie.
A big disappointment after Billy Jones' second-minute goal. Morecambe.